This video shows how to create 3D animation for your model. We'll consider a model consisting of a simple flowchart: source, queue, conveyor, sink. Process modeling library blocks do not have built-in animations. We need to draw them ourselves using the AnyLogic space markup shapes, paths, and nodes. We'll start with drawing a space markup shape for the conveyor. Double-click the path element in the space markup palette and draw the path point by point. Since we plan to create 3D animation, ensure that Show in 2D and 3D is selected in the Advanced section of the path's properties. Link the path to the flowchart block. Select the Conveyor flowchart block. Navigate to its properties and click the button next to the Agent Location list. The path will be highlighted and we will be able to select it. This way, we make this path the animation guideline shape for items being transported by the conveyor. To observe 3D animation, we need to use the 3D window element from the presentation palette. We'll drag it onto the main agent diagram and place it below the visible area. Let's run the model. Initially, the model is animated in 2D. To switch to 3D, click the Navigate to View Area button and select Window 3D, which is the name of the view area that AnyLogic creates automatically when you add a 3D window. As you can see, the conveyor is represented by the line, and the transported goods are represented by the colored circles. Let's make our model look more realistic. We'll add 3D models for the boxes that are transported by the conveyor. Select the source block and navigate to its properties. Click the Create a Custom Type link to create a new type of agent that will be generated by this block. In the New Agent wizard, name the agent type Box and select a 3D animation shape for it. Next, we'll make the path look like a conveyor belt by navigating to the Appearance section of its properties and setting Type to Conveyor. Our boxes shouldn't be left unattended. We need to add a worker. Drag the Worker 3D object from the 3D Objects palette and position it near the conveyor. Accept the AnyLogic offer to auto-resize the object to match the model scale. If your model animation requires a custom object that is not available in the 3D Objects gallery, you can import it in the form of an X3D or VRML file. Let's run the model and switch to 3D animation. To pan around the scene, press and hold the left mouse button and move the mouse in the required direction. To rotate the scene, press and hold the Alt key, press and hold the left mouse button, and move the mouse in the required rotation direction. To zoom in or out, simply scroll the mouse wheel. The conveyor belt appears to be lying on the ground. Let's move it upwards. To do that, select the conveyor shape and set its Z coordinate to 10. Now, add a rectangle element from the presentation palette to act as the model's ground. It must be sent to back to not cover other objects. In the appearance section of the rectangle's properties, set fill color to texture and choose the grass texture. Then set line color to no color. When you run the model, the rectangle is displayed in both 2D as a rectangle and 3D as a parallelepiped. As you can see, it's covering the worker animation figure. We can fix this issue by adjusting the rectangle's vertical height. The height is specified in the Z height property of the shape. It's currently set to 10, so let's set it to 0. You may have noticed that we pan and zoom the 3D scene each time on running the model. We can avoid this by adding the camera object from the presentation palette and linking it to the 3D window. Run the model and navigate the scene to find the best viewpoint. Right-click the scene and select Copy Camera Location to use it in the camera's positioning settings. We can now select the camera object and click the Paste Coordinates from Clipboard button in its Properties to apply the copied positioning settings. The camera will be positioned exactly where we want it to be. Note that we can still navigate the 3D scene, but we may want to disallow the camera movement below the ground. In the 3D window properties, set navigation type to limited to Z above 0. Now, pay attention to the light. Our 3D scene looks a bit dark. We can customize its lighting with the help of the light element from the presentation palette. In our case, we'll use two light sources and leave the default street light type. And that's it! Adding 3D animation brings your model to a significantly new level. Thanks for watching, and come back for more AnyLogic how-to videos.